Hey there, if you're using a Huion tablet or a pen display, or you're thinking about making the switch from a mouse, then today's video is for you. So today I'm going to share my top tips to help you get the absolute most out of your tablet, from customizing express keys to perfecting your pen pressure, whether you're into retouching portraits or painting or editing other kinds of photos. These tips are going to help you level up your workflow. And yes, I'm even going to tell you why this little display screen beats a mouse hands down. So let's jump in. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into my Huion driver panel and I'm going to show you how to set up various buttons. So I'm going to go into my driver panel, which is this little one down here. It's got the blue thing with the pen. After you've set up your display, what you need to do is go into your drivers and you can set up your working area and stuff like that. But one of the things you really need to do is set up the buttons on the side here. Now, I've got little stickers on mine. I'm hoping you can see. So I've got little stickers on mine and each of those do something separate. So if I click on it and hover, as you can see here, then it will do different things. So what I want to do is I want to create custom keyboard shortcuts for each of the buttons down the side. Now, my first one is undo, which is Control Z. Then I have B, which is for my brush. Then I have V, which gives me the move tool on Photoshop. These are all set up for Photoshop. Then there's Control Save, which is to save. I've also got R to rotate the screen. I also have Shift, just the Shift button. I've got just the Alt button. And then I have the Control Zero on my number pad, which gives me full screen. Now, I also have this little Huion dial here as well, which is also an added bonus. So I can switch over on my screen to my mini dial, and then I can go through and I can set all of these up on my mini dial. So there's some really cool stuff that we can do here. Once you've got all that set up, I'm going to go back to my tablet. I am going to set up, or I'm going to calibrate my screen. So what I'm going to do is select the working area, and I've got two screens, so that's why it's here. So this is my other screen, this is my main screen. So I want my working area set to my main screen. The other thing that I want to do is I want to calibrate my monitor. Now, you don't have to do this every time you start, but if you've had it unplugged for a while or had your computer turned off because you've gone away for a while, it's always a good idea to come and recalibrate. So all you have to do then is you get your pen and you just touch on the red dot. And that then has your monitor completely calibrated. The next thing that you want to set up is your pen pressure. So we're going to switch over to digital pen and we're going to pick up the pen. We're going to adjust our pressure sensitivity settings. So if we come in here and click there, then you can decide on what sensitivity you want your pen to be. So you can do a test. And you can decide how sensitive you want your pen to be. My next suggestion is to keep your screen clear. So you can get something, you know, just the LCD cleaning liquid, give it a bit of a spray, and you can clean over that with just a really gentle cloth. It's a good idea, especially when you're retouching, to give your surface a really good clean area to work on. That way you can then tell what is a dirty spot on your image and what is a dirty spot on your screen. The next thing I want to talk about is think about ergonomics. Prop your canvas up at a comfortable angle. Now, if I put my, just move my pen over there, I have got my stand that comes with my tablet set up there. And you can put it on different angles. You can have it flat on the desk or you can have it up a little bit higher. But work on something that is comfortable for you. Make sure that you've still got your mouse, if you need it, and your keyboard and things like that within reach, so you're not constantly twisting and bending and trying to find it. I tend to either have my keyboard, so that's my keyboard, just in front of my tablet, or I will put it just off to the side if I think I'm not going to use it. I could also put it just on top as well. So just to have it nearby. The other thing you might want to think about doing if you're doing photography or digital art and accurate colors matter is run a color calibration tool or a monitor calibration tool like the Spider X, like this one here. And I will put a link below, but you set that up on your monitor and I'll put a link in how to do a calibration as well. I think I've got a video there somewhere. And you run that through. So this ensures that your canvas matches your final output, your screen matches your final output. It's super important for skin tones and print work and things like that. Choose whether you want to mirror your device or if you want to extend it. I prefer sort of the mirror mode. But it's up to you which way you want to go. You can decide on if you want to go full area and all the rest of it. But what you also need to do is go into your settings. This really is going to depend on whether you're working on Windows or whatever. But if you go into your display settings on your computer, and then you can set up which way you want it, whether you want to have multiple desktop one or two, different layouts, what you want to have it set up to. So why does a pen beat a mouse? Almost every time. And here's the thing. A mouse was never designed for precision art. Sure, it allows you to go around your screen and you can click on it and do things like that. But basic everyday tasks, the mouse is fine. So when you are trying to do pressure sensitive or you want to go into fine detail and you're doing something like retouching or you are doing fine art work, coming in with a pen allows you to grab far more detail and accurate detail than you're going to get with a mouse. It's also, I think, more intuitive and it's more natural and it's a lot more comfortable for really long editing sessions. Once you get used to it, I think you'll find there's no going back. Does it take a long time to get used to it? No, I don't think it does. But everybody's different. Some, like my display pen, is going to take a little bit more time to get used to than just a plain graphics tablet where you're still using your own monitor. But some people find having the hand-eye coordination for something like this is easier when you've got a display pen. So those are my top tips for getting the most out of your Huion Kamvas tablet. It'll probably work for other brands as well. If you're new to digital art or photo editing or just want to work faster and smarter, I hope this gives you a great head start with your tablet. Let me know in the comments what's your favorite shortcut or tip to use with your tablet. And if you found this helpful, don't forget to give it a like, maybe share it with a creative friend or two, and don't forget to subscribe for more photography and creative tips every week. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.